In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. May the peace of the Lord Jesus, the love of God, the gifts of the Holy Spirit be with you. We prepare our hearts to celebrate the sacred mysteries. We ask forgiveness for our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, reward the merits of the just and offer pardon to sinners who do penance, have mercy on those who call upon you, that the admission of our guilt may serve to attain your pardon for our sins. This we ask through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, in a time of favor I answer you, on the day of salvation I help you, and I have kept you and given you as a covenant to the people, to restore the land and allot the desolate heritages, saying to the prisoners, come out, to those in darkness, show yourselves. Along the ways they shall find pasture, on every bare height shall their pastures be. They shall not hunger or thirst, nor shall the scorching wind or the sun strike them. For he who pites them leads them and guides them beside springs of water. I will cut a road through all my mountains and make my highways level. See, some shall come from afar, others from the north and the west, and some from the land of Cyrene. Sing out, O heavens, and rejoice, O earth. Break forth into song, you mountains. For the Lord comforts his people and shows mercy to the afflicted. But Zion said, the Lord has forsaken me. My Lord has forgotten me. Can a mother forget her child? Be without tenderness for the child in her womb? Even should she forget, I shall never forget you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord is gracious and merciful. The Lord is gracious and merciful. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. The Lord is gracious and merciful. The Lord is faithful in all his works and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are falling and raises up all who are bowed down. The Lord is gracious and merciful. The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth. The Lord is gracious and merciful. The verse before the gospel. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die.
The The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus answered the Jews, "My Father is at work until now, so I am at work." For this reason they tried all the more to kill him, because he not only broke the Sabbath, but he also called God his own Father, making himself equal to God. Jesus answered and said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, the Son cannot do anything on his own, but only what he sees the Father doing. For what he does, the Son will do also. For the Father loves the Son and shows him everything that he himself does, and he will show him greater works than these, so that you may be amazed. For just as the Father raises the dead and gives life, so also does the Son give life to whomever he wishes. Nor does the Father judge anyone, but he has given all judgment to the Son, so that all may honor the Son just as they honor the Father. Whoever does not honor the Son does not honor the Father who sent him. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life and will not come to condemnation, but has passed from death to life. Amen, amen, I say to you, the hour is coming and is now here, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so also he gave to the Son the possession of life in himself. And he gave him power to exercise judgment, because he is the Son of Man. Do not be amazed at this, because the hour is coming in which all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and will come out. Those who have done good deeds to the resurrection of life, but those who have done wicked deeds to the resurrection of condemnation. I cannot do anything on my own. I judge as I hear, and my judgment is just, because I do not seek my own will, but the will of the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we hear from the prophet Isaiah, part of the suffering servants. Isaiah will hear this week and also during Holy Week. But in the beautiful phrase towards the end of the prophet, Isaiah says, "Sing out, O heavens, and rejoice, O earth. Break forth into song, you mountains. For the Lord comforts his people, shows mercy to his afflicted." This great positive invitation to sing to the mountains comes when the Israelites people, God's chosen people, are held in captivity. Their lives are miserable. They've been taken from their homeland. They are serving other people. And yet in the midst of this terrible situation comes this invitation to sing, to give praise to God, for the Lord comforts his people. We will soon hear, as we heard on Sunday, how King Cyrus will eventually release the Israelite people to go home. But all this points, as we hear in Isaiah, to the Christ, the Last Supper, the New Covenant that is formed on Holy Thursday with the body and blood of Christ. And so it's a great reminder to us that in this Lenten season, as we are called to be mindful of our own sinful lives, that in the midst of our sorrow for our sins will come an opportunity to come back to life, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God. Those who hear will live. It is not only those who are in the earthy grave, but also those who are in the grave of sin, to hear anew the invitation to return to the Lord with all our hearts. A great reminder that next Wednesday at St. Matthias, 12 hours of reconciliation, beginning at 8 a.m. till 8 p.m., there'll be 6 priests there every hour to hear confessions. May we make our Lenten confession, if we haven't already, next Wednesday at St. Matthias, hearing God's voice to come out of our tombs, that we may live forever and ever with Christ our Savior. So let us rise as we pray for our needs in confidence.
For all Christians, as we continue our Lenten disciplines of prayer, fasting, and almsgiving, may we experience anew God's fair faithfulness and so come to share in the promise of the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are preparing to be baptized this Easter, may they have a deeper awareness of God's loving and transforming presence in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from trials of any kind, may Jesus sustain them and grant them hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are of us gathered here, may the Holy Spirit pour out upon us his steadfast love and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they come to share in the fullness of Christ's glory in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, religious life, holy marriage, permanent diaconate, and single life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in public office, that they may be inspired by the Holy Spirit to serve and protect all life, from conception to natural death, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those remembered in our prayer petition thank you book, that through God's everlasting love, they will receive the help they need, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Joe Kloiber and deceased Michael O'Connell, for whom this Mass is offered, and all those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, you've shown us your love and mercy through the gift of your Son, Jesus. In his name we trust all our prayers, as he is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. May the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, mercifully wipe away what is old in us and increase in us grace of salvation and newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through bodily fasting you restrain our faults, raise up our minds, and bestow both virtue and its rewards through Christ. Through Jesus, the angels praise your majesty. May our voices join with theirs in humble praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, you are the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus always be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word. Let us pray. God, our Creator, may your heavenly gifts, which you bestow as a heavenly remedy on your people, not bring judgment to those who receive them, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and errors of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits, prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Our Lady of Sorrows,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Go in God's peace.
Thanks be to God.
O sacrament most holy.